Whew, now that's unsettling.
Like, wow. I'm sure glad we don't look like that.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Wait! You're a dog? This wedding is off!
I thought you knew!
But in this courtroom, it's my job to reveal who the monster really is. Yes, the real bad guy is Fred Jones!
Is that true? I'm a big boy! A big boy who could have removed those dumb girls' brains no problem if I wanted to!
Guilty!
Based on what?
Unfunny people do nothing in the face of evil funny people, Wayne. Then evil funny people win. And I, Velma Dinkley, am the unfunniest of them all!
But we're playing Virtual Camping 3.
Yeah, and we've been desensitized to the beauty of nature.
But you're missing stuff, like this majestic tree.
Yes, the majestic tree level.
How about that soaring eagle? It's soaring! Does it drop acorn bombs? We've been desensitized to soaring. We need acorn bombs to hold our attention.
A Viking ghost with a huge battle axe!
How big is the axe? We've been desensitized to Norse weaponry under 3 feet long.
Fine. There's a farmer's market up ahead. We'll stop. If you tell your digestive systems to stop mocking me.
Like, I hardly think you're in a position to make demands here, buddy.
Light it up. Huh. At least I follow my own orders.
Hi, excuse my father. I'm Beth. He means our inventory is light because we've had some trouble down on the farm.
You deciphered all that from nope?
Yep.
My father's a man of few words. Three, actually. Nope, yep, and meddling. Though I'm not sure in what context he'll ever use that last one.
If I solve this mystery, I, Fred Jones, would become part of that legend. They would call me El Federico.
You know that just means the Fred, right?
The Fred.
Everyone sign the wedding guest book. A tradition as old as signatures.
Yep.
No, we are not selling the farm. I've never seen him so upset.
100 years ago, a photographer was trying to take a picture of a very large wedding party on the cliff's edge, but he couldn't get everyone in frame. So he asked them all to take a few steps back. What were the chances a story like that could be true?
In our experience, 100%.
Look, the cake, the ultimate wedding symbol, still stands. That means there's still hope. Let's take off and ride the roller coaster.
I'll come with you. While I have no great love for roller coasters, clowns are worse.
Well, Shaggy and Scooby, I guess that's more mystery for us to solve.
Nah, we're cool. You can have the whole thing to yourself.
Have fun? But the first step is splitting up to look for clues. Doesn't anyone care about protocol anymore? One person can't split up! Guys, we're in the wilderness. Nature provides the best, freshest delicacies you'd ever want. Plump, juicy blackberries, huge hazelnuts, fresh salmon from the stream with wild asparagus, cooked spring dandelions, steamed kudzu, ripe gooseberries, and pine needle tea. Talk about five-star meal.
What can I get you fellas?
Nothing, thank you. We're professionals.
Yes, please stand back.
Snacks are the artistic medium through which I work out all my problems. This rice cereal treat shaped like my dog who ran away when I was 10.
Come on, pumpkin!
Look, that murder of crows is eating all the food we're supposed to be eating all of. At least I think that's a murder. How many crows makes up a murder?
More than that.
So it's more like a traffic violation of crows.
Yes! We can finally get our grant money and only eat moss because we like it.
Do you mind if we look around?
I can't stop you. Legally.
Thanks.
Officers, escort them out of town. If I catch you here again, I look forward to facing you in a real court of law.
I'm leaving you, Dayton, for him.
Hey, none of that last part happened.
Well, that's the way I've been telling it.
I'll allow it because the imagery amuses me.
I don't have to sit here and be insulted. Have fun with your little trial because I am history.
Wait, Mr. Rogers, did you say Fred is a connoisseur of vintage 1950s ascots?
Like, in a good way, though.
A fan of 1950s fashion just happens to come across an abandoned 1950s town. He claims he didn't find a neckwear shop, but he's wearing a vintage 1950s ascot in this very courtroom. Is he not?
I thought you were a scary clown, but not that you look like a scary clown because of your makeup. It's just, no, I mean, once that I got a good look at you, what are you doing here?
Well, let me give you some friendly advice. Watch your step.
There's dry rot everywhere. A fella could take a bad tumble. I'm okay. Can we pretend that last part didn't happen and I left on that cooler line?
On the ambiguously veiled threat?
Yeah, that part. Fella could take a tumble, blah, blah, blah.
Fine.
Thanks.
How long before Shaggy and Scooby come running screaming back to the campsite?
Oh, Velma, ye of little faith. Should be another 2 minutes.
Sounds about right.
They're early. My instincts tell me something must be wrong. Okay, now my instincts are saying fight or flight.
Flight!
Flight it is. Take him away, officers.
And now just hold your horses. If there's natural gas under both our land, we're both rich, right? I'm not pressing charges, are you?
Nope.
Wait, did you just try to send my father to jail?
Meddling.
But I solved the mystery. He called us the M word. On three. One, two, three.
Shaggy and Scooby are so lucky to be best friends. A boy and his dog. It's adorable how even their stomachs have a secret language.
I thought you had a pet growing up, Daphne.
Sure, we had show horses. Oh, and Mother had a show cat named Show Horse. But I never had my own pet, like Scooby.
Or Shaggy. I'm still not clear which one is the pet in that relationship.
Like, this doesn't look right. Fred, can you help me? Scoob, can you help me with this thing?
And that looks like an old-timey desperado skeleton with a mustache.
Really? I think it looks like a human toe trying to explain photosynthesis to a donut.
See? Camping is a chance to hone in on our natural instincts. Out here, it's survival of the fittest. Predator and prey, mystery solver and mystery solvee.
Fred, do you really actually see all human activity as an opportunity to enhance one's mystery-solving skills? Or are you just being silly to annoy me?
Speaking of which...
What? When I was a little girl, I dreamed of being a nature ranger. But Mother wouldn't allow it. She said the outdoors is just a giant bathroom that wants to eat you.
Wise woman, some believe loved ones return to impart an important message to the living.
Well, I'm getting a message loud and clear. Leave!
I hear it.
Get that a lot.
So, being the professionals that we are, we ran screaming for our lives. Tin Man, there he is! Like, where have you been, Scarecrow?
Hello, Yellow Road, follow?
Okay, it's simple. Just follow the Yellow Road to Emerald City. Avoid being ripped apart by flying blue monkeys.
Generally good advice.
Next, destroy the Wicked Witch.
Hint, no likey wawa.
And finally berate the Good Witch for not telling Dorothy her magic red shoes could have sent her home immediately at the beginning.
Complete waste of time.
Got it?
Whoa.
Great, get a move on. Go on, follow the hastily assembled, obviously fake yellowish road.
Sniff Toto for me.
There's one thing I can't stand, it's tardiness. None of your lip, young man. I mean, literally, you don't have lips. What's up with that? Now, sit. My name is Professor. I couldn't think of a name fast enough. I teach Monster 101. In this class, you'll learn how to be the most horrifying creature you can be. I expect great things from you. I saw that. Passing notes? Get it here. Okay, that's it, young man. To the principal's office with you. Now we've got a record. Man, you changed. He used to be about the music. Now you're throwing tantrums. He wants songwriting credit, and he's letting his girlfriend break up the band.
You're better than them.
That's it. I'm going solo.
I love your new sound.
Ha ha ha!
where'd he go?
Well, that was anticlimactic.
There's no handle on this door.
Like, I guess they figured no one ever needs to get out of a tomb.
I would have gotten away with it, too, if that meddling lawyer didn't discover that surprise envelope with evidence that proved who the toxic mutant really was.
You mean this?
Does anyone else see a pig?
Little stray baby pig.
Technically, I don't think there are any stray animals on a farm, Daphne.
This pig, this bunny, and I are like a family that's trying desperately to get away from each other at any cost. Like a family. We're the new Shaggy and Scooby. Daphne and Duffy and Dinky. We have so much in common. Nostrils, for one. Oh, and we birth our young live in amniotic sacs.
Come on, you two, focus. And gross. Looks like we got away, for now.
But you're not getting away from the long arm of natural law. Illegally chopping down a tree, illegally riding down a river, and illegally crashing. Even worse, I didn't personally care for the music playing while it happened.
But it wasn't our fault. There were these Vikings and...
Oh, here we go with more Vikings. Tell it to the forest judge. You're going to forest jail.
I'll say it. Forest jail? It's not half as fun as it sounded.
I'm sorry, gang. I thought camping would hone our instincts and make us better mystery solvers, not get us thrown into forest jail.
Plus, we've all turned 18, so we'll be tried as forest adults.
Speaking of clean freak, I think the Daphne gang needs to find a bathroom, apart from my dress.
Well, Beth, it's been great chatting with you, but I need to take my highly trained associates back into the field. Don't worry, we'll have this case solved in no time.
Dippy! Yuck!
Last chance for snacks? Like, do they mean forever?
That's not...
A life without snacks?
I don't think...
That's no life at all!
But we have to stop!
Oh, you know, I bet that sign just meant last chance for snacks within city limits.
That makes more sense.
I wonder if you wouldn't mind too terribly getting off us.
All right, guys. When the Vikings take the bait, you and Scoob lead them this way through my gauntlet of traps.
I don't know, Fred. That's an awful lot of traps.
Exactly. They'll never see it coming. Unless they come from the other direction.
I'm a giant!
It's true, weddings are supposed to be beautiful, wonderful, perfect fantasies. But never forget, weddings are also supposed to be scary, stress-filled, horrible nightmares.
Scoob, look! You know that reoccurring dream you have about squirting water onto someone wearing heavy pancake makeup until their hat explodes?
It's a real thing?
Yes!
These tracks were made by a truck!
Obviously.
Fred, that's always where we stack the hay. This is a fairly typical farm, as you can see.
Yes, of course. It's very full of farm.
Ah, here. Bippy's Law School Adventure. When you beat the final level, you're a lawyer.
Daphne, you can't become a lawyer by winning a video game.
Jump! Duck! Jump! They're throwing circumstantial evidence at Bippy!
Give Jonathan this. And tell him he needs to back off if he knows what's good for him.
Okay.
Achoo!
Cousin tight.
Thanks?
Beware. I foresee great suffering for you. I always keep a little tissue packet on me.
Objection! It's too late to bring in new evidence. The prosecution hasn't even had a chance to say it.
I'll allow it.
You've got to be kidding! This is the biggest farce of a trial I've ever been involved in! A defense attorney who passed the bar in a video game? Testimony from a dog? Evidence thrown out because it hurts the defense's case? That's it! I'm walking! I mean it this time! I'm not coming back! So stop looking over here! I can't stop doing this!
I smell... wild sandwich.
Scooby! You did it! You foraged!
Hold on, Scoob. I have a plan.
Like, wouldn't this plan work with only half a sandwich? And isn't the real mystery here why someone threw away a perfectly good ham on rye?
Yes.
Shaggy?
I don't think this is... Okay,
give it the sandwich!
Where'd you guys find those?
Like, they were under a blanket in the back of that pickup truck over there.
Hold it. I just beat level 3, and technically these suits are illegal contraband, though it would be hard to prove animus furandi.
Oh, give it up, Daphne. There is no way a side-scrolling platform game can take the place of years of law school.
Oh, yeah? Wanna bet?
You know perfectly well I don't believe in gambling, but since I know I'm right, it's not technically a gamble. What do you want to wager? Huh? Me. Bald.
Oh, that was a bad bet.
Your Honor, this is totally irrelevant!
Welcome to Safety Springs. That's the name of the toxic meltdown town? Time to don my irony hat!
Not the irony hat.
Look, Scoob, the Safety Springs school mascot is the friendly molecule. Like, where's Daphne's irony hat when you need it?
Clip.
Yeah, keep talking. You'll soon be wearing your irony hat for practical reasons. Clip.
Fippy has a video game for virtually every situation, not just getting your law degree.
Wait, how did you say you got your law degree?
Sorry I tried to force an unnaturally deep, unending bond of love between us, guys. You're free to go. The final piece was the excavation permit, which Ranger Mark threw out to prevent the archaeologists from continuing their work, proving his involvement. I did it! I earned my recapping a mystery patch! That's the last, if not the most strangely convenient, one of all! I'm officially a non-official nature ranger! In your face, fake Viking logger crooks!
And we would have gotten away with it, too, if you meddling kids weren't so excited to eat food out of the trash.
I'll live with that. We Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Oh, come on.